Coming back to my parents' house in the Central Coast is way different than living in the city. So it's always good to film. I'm finally getting the tooth whitening video out for you guys. Myths, things you should know, and one simple tip that people think is so simple, but it's very effective on keeping the stains off your teeth and overall keeping them whiter. Coming up in this video. First, let's get into what is it that dentists use and why is it so expensive to whitening your teeth? Well, it's one, it's time and materials that we use. But what do we usually use? We usually either use hydrogen peroxide or carbamide peroxide. Hydrogen is usually stronger, usually at a lower percentage, or higher percentage. If you're gonna get that thumbnail from 1 to 7, yes, it is possible. It's gonna be a heavy whitening. Gonna have to be in office with the UV light. But, you know, let's get into some of the myths and let's debunk some of this stuff. Some of the stuff I see online is pretty ridiculous. So how does the whitening actually work? The way it works is the direct contact of the product with the tooth in this oxidative process, but what it requires is time. It has to be in contact with the tooth for a certain amount of time. And you know, on things like this, you know, advanced whitening toothpaste, it's kind of a gimmick. And yes, it does have the product, like a hydrogen peroxide that we would use to do that, but it's just not long enough on the tooth. You usually need at least 1 hour, sometimes 3 hours if it's a weaker product. And trust me, you don't leave toothpaste on for that long for it to do anything. So like I said, it's all about contact and length of time that it does that. Now there are some funny things I've been seeing on the internet of ways to kind of whiten your teeth, like an orange peel, rub it on your teeth, and supposedly it's supposed to help. Can it? I guess if you look at what the reasoning, it kind of helps. It's saying that it has vitamins and stuff that protects your teeth. But if it really comes down to it, that's like charcoal toothpaste, the strawberry, you know, paste that you make. Can it help? Maybe, but what it really comes down to is removing stains from your teeth first with a proper cleaning from a hygienist or a dentist, and then using a product, like I said, hydrogen peroxide, carbamide peroxide. So what I'm trying to say is that, you know, those Crest white strips that you see on the store, those actually do work. Just make sure your teeth have gotten a cleaning to remove some of those superficial stains so that it can penetrate evenly. There are some stains that are a little different. You can't take off. You know, some people have these brown stains that they got from antibiotics when they were younger. Those you're not going to remove no matter how much you stain. Those require veneers. Regular whitening will not work on those. So talk to your dentist. That's why it's usually more advised that you keep in contact with people that know what they're doing so that you're not just like wasting your money on stuff that doesn't work. Like I said, that 1 to 7 days, is that possible to get your teeth from that yellow to that white? Yes, it's possible, but usually you're going to have to go to a dentist and have professional work done in order to get that to happen. As far as my tip as what you can do to prevent stains, we all like things like coffee, soda, orange juice, wine, beer. All that stuff has staining properties. Even when you eat strawberries and you bite into them, it all has a way to stain your teeth, and you know, you usually brush it off. But the easiest way, if you do like to, you know, engage in those kind of beverages, is you have to drink through a straw. I had a patient who was about 55 years old, had the whitest teeth, and I thought for sure this patient is whitening their teeth consistently. And the patient told me, no, I've just all my life drinking everything through a straw. And honestly, that's probably the best tip I could give you in terms of keeping stains off your teeth once you do whitening. There's no time limit of when you can do whitening or have to wait this long before you whiten again. But the only thing I would be careful of is that we do have a natural bluish hue to our teeth as they get whiter and whiter. So you can whiten them to a point where your teeth start to look blue. Now, if you have any specific questions about whitening and whitening products that you want to know, leave a comment below.